have to do something 10,000 times before your body will ever commit to muscle memory. All right? So we're going to do head outside single. Now I told you, there's only four penetration steps in the sport of wrestling. And we'll cover all four this week. We only touch on one for a brief moment. And Coach Jordan usually teaches that session. So he'll go through the four penetration steps when he's over here teaching. But understand this, and I hear coaches say this a lot, I don't necessarily agree with it. Why? Because they're wrong and I'm right. But this position, I hear a lot of people say that this is high crouch position. No, this is a single leg. This is a head outside single leg position. What determines whether it's a high crouch or a head outside single is your penetration step. We'll cover the high crouch penetration step later this week. I told you that we teach our guys at Graham to go out to beat this guy's head, kill this guy's head, all right, until he does this, and we pin. All right, we do that by being physical. A head outside single is a knee over toe penetration step. A knee over toe penetration step is always used to cover distance. When you're being the bully and you're being the aggressor, you have to cover distance. Why? This guy's backing up. He's running away from you, which Mario often does. So I have a lot of head outside single or knee over toe penetration step to cover the distance to chase him down and beat him up. All right, so I can pin. That's the ultimate in the sport of wrestling, guys, is to get the pin every time. At my junior high, my kids love the pin. That's all they want to do. Coach, can I pin him yet? They look at me and say this stuff during the match. I'm like, keep wrestling. All right? They love to pin. But they need to work on being the aggressor going out, working on all their penetrations. Understand this. Every time you get to this position, it is not necessarily called a high crouch. It's not necessarily called a head outside single. It is based on the penetration step you use to get there, determines what it's called. Right now, it's a head outside single. We're going to use a knee over toe penetration to cover distance to get to Marco's leg. Makes sense? Here we go. We're going to now do a double inside tie. So my guard's eye hand is simply going to go from his neck down here to this inside tie. I'm still going to circle to my left. Trust me, I'll make it make sense after we get this position down. My head still drops into the pocket. Here, I will line up over the back of my stance here. I'm going to circle, change level and direction, and pull down to get Mario to do what?
Pull up.
To do what?
Yeah.
To raise up. Why? I got to beat his head and his hands. First thing I got to beat is his head. I do that by being lower. How do I get lower than him? I change levels, plus I pull down to get him to raise up. I do this right here. I circle, I pull down. Here as he raises up, my hands are inside. My right leg steps. Here, I drive my knee over my toe. My trail leg steps up high. I drive up. I went into Mario. What should I do next? Circle back. I'm going to do this right here. I want you to notice, my head is up, my back is straight. My hips are underneath me. My arms are pulling, and my elbows are pulling right back here into my stance. I'm in good position. Biggest mistake I see you guys make is you want to drop your lock way down here. You want to do this. You want to pinch with your knees, pull it on right here. Like, yeah, I got it. You got nothing. Mario's going to kill me in this position. Why? I can't move. I have no mobility. My lock's way down here. My head's down. My legs are straight. I'm in big, big, big trouble. All right? I have my lock right here above Mario's knee. I just take my left hand and I grab my right wrist. And I pull down and in on Mario's leg. I'm trying to pull his hip out of socket. Notice, my shoulder is tight. It's on the inside of his body. My ear is up high, and I'm leaning into Mario this way. I'm driving with my head across. From here, I've got mobility. I'm going to go into him. I can circle back. Into him. Circle back. Whole time, I'm right here in my stance. Are you with me on that? That's the biggest mistake I see, is you guys have your lock way down here and you're like Frankenstein footing around trying to circle. It's never going to work. Head up, back straight, hips underneath me. Into a circle back motion. New setup. I want you guys to concentrate on the setup. That's why I'm showing you this. Screw the finish, fellas. If I don't get to his legs, I don't need to finish. I don't. Why? I can't get a leg. I don't need to know how to finish. I need to know how to get to the leg. Here, double inside tie. My hand drops from this collar tie. Down here to an inside tie. I start to change on the direction. Here. Right leg steps. Here, toe penetration. My short leg steps up. I go into him. Circle back. Into him. Circle back. That's all I want to see for right now. Defense man, do me a favor. Be a good partner. Hop on one foot. Let's do it, won't you? Let me try to explain something to you. Anytime you look like this, this is called fear. This is how you hold your head here at night when you're scared. Alright? This is called fear. I'm not going to hug Mario's leg. I'm not going to do this. Why? Look how far my head is now. Look at my butt sticking way out, my legs getting straight. I want your chin and your hands as far apart as you can. You guys feel like, oh, I don't have the leg tight. You don't have to hug his leg to have it tight. Look. My hands and my chin are as far apart as I can keep them. Here, I'm pulling down and in on this leg. Is there pressure here on your leg going up? Yeah, there's pressure. He's not going anywhere. I'm using my entire body to control Mario right now. Don't do this. This is bad. This is hugging his leg. Don't hug it. His leg is not my mom. It is not my teddy bear. It is not dark outside. I am not scared. Don't hug his leg, all right? So I want you to understand why I'm circling to the left. Number one, I circle to the left because it puts me actually closer to this leg. Number two, it's actually going to speed me up. Number three, I'm in a better position. Here's what happens. Here's how everybody's taught. Pull that leg to you. Get that leg close. Get weight on that foot. And wrong. If I circle to my right, I'm actually going to be in worse position and slower than if I circle to my inside thigh. Here's why I circle left. If I circle to my right, I want you to see something. Here, I've got to take one, two, three steps. My fourth step is going to be my penetration step. Here, and I want you to see how far my trail leg is back. I have to bring my trail leg all the way from here to create an angle. So now I took four steps and had to move my trail leg 5 feet to get this angle right here. Not only did I have to move my trail leg 5 feet, but if I don't move my trail leg, I want you to look at this position. My body's facing this direction. This makes it really, really easy for Mario to go to what we call the crank down position. My shoulder's already facing the outside. All he does is start to zip his butt. He's got my shoulder beat right there. So it took me four steps, and I had to move my trail leg a huge, huge distance. And I'm pointed across his body. I have the exact opposite angle of the angle I want. I'm here. I'm not square to Mario, but I want to get to this position. Does that make sense? Now, if I circle to my left, I want you to watch. Here, I circle. Here, I plant my left foot. That's not even a step. Why? That's already part of my motion. I take one step. Now look, I'm already square with Mario right here. I drive my knee over my toe. My shoulder's still here. My trail leg steps up. Look at the position I'm in. From here, it's easy. I've got the angle. Does that make any sense at all? I just gained three steps on Mario. By circling the right direction, I don't have to take four steps. I take one step. I move my trail leg a shorter distance.